Hey everyone, it's been a while. I don't have any witty or themed intro prepared for you guys this time, so let's just get right into it. The film that I watched recently was The Florida Project by Sean Baker.
The man who lives in here gets arrested a lot.
These are the rooms we're not supposed to go in.
But let's go anyway.
Could you give us some change, please?
The doctor said we have asthma and we gotta eat ice cream right away.
Here you go.
Now, the only film I've seen from this director is Tangerine, a film widely known for only being shot on iPhone 5Ss. Although that film was beautiful, the iPhone digital quality lessened the beauty of several shots. But that's not the situation for this film, thank God, because it was shot on 35mm film. So many shots in this film just look beautiful. I'm glad that he shot on film instead of an iPhone like in Tangerine, because this time he gets to express so many gorgeous shots perfectly. Although, one scene at the end was shot on an iPhone, but I'll get to that later because that's a whole different story and a whole different criticism right there. Also, when I'm showing you a part of the trailer, a huge part of me did not want to show you any of it. Because it's very misleading. It's not a coming-of-age film like Stand By Me as it portrays. To be exact, it's more of an in-depth look into Florida trash. This isn't the first time Sean Baker has directed a film about trashy people. That said, don't expect any likable character in this film because almost everyone is complete another asshole. But that's the point, as you can view this as an overall character study. While watching this film, the plot isn't exactly what you expect. Without giving any spoilers away, several scenes feel very repetitive and causes the film to have a slow pace. There are scenes in the film which don't seem to serve any purpose to aid the story or bring the audience closer to the world of Florida trash. These scenes are a minor detriment to the film, primarily because it felt excruciating to get through only a few moments in the film. That doesn't mean the whole film wasn't enjoyable. Each character felt realistic with layers of depth to them. Yes, they do have the simple title of Florida Trash, but still characterized genuinely in their actions and principles like actual people. The film never goes the way portraying them to mock them, even though they do really ridiculous things. It more presents itself as an observation to their lives. Other than the repetitive scenes I talked about, the film had a steady pace towards the ending where it could have ended completely fine. It could have fit like a glove. But that ending, oh boy, was it horrible. If you don't want spoilers, skip to this time, on screen, right now. So, these are minor spoilers, as I can't describe the ending without mentioning every event that set it into complete motion. I'll just say what the director meant to be executed and how it failed. So it was a dream sequence with two children running all the way towards Disney World. However, the immediate cut to the horrible frame rate, camera quality, and editing just felt horribly cheesy and amateurish. Not to the point where I can laugh at it, but I just felt secondhand embarrassment. It's painfully obvious that they had the recorder on an iPhone because they obviously didn't have permission to film on Disney property. How did I know? Well, as the two children ran through people in Disney World, a lot of people's faces were blurred out, showing how they didn't have permission to shoot there. If the film just cut straight to black before that sequence, right before that sequence, it would have been a suffice ending. I was tearing up before that scene, and adding it there just felt so out of place and could have worked a lot better without it. Even though it was such a short sequence, for me, it soured all the buildup the film had for that ending. Okay, to wrap this up, I have to say that The Florida Project is a movie that I enjoyed watching, even though it felt very repetitive and the ending was trash, like the characters in it. Even though I didn't mention the child actors, they are phenomenal. The characters and how they acted paralleled kids I actually met here in LA. So yeah, Florida Trash, similar to LA Trash. It is in theaters right now, and if you'd like a glimpse into Florida Trash, I'd fully recommend. I give it a 6 out of 10. Hey, sorry guys, a little message at the end. I haven't had the emotional drive to finish my script for a review I had scheduled for Christmas. But I don't know, maybe I'll get it done by then. In the meantime, I have two other types of videos, not reviews, coming up on the channel. Hope you guys can look forward to it. See ya!